saying to Carl, I've read about him for years now, I guess, and I've always wanted to meet you, so thanks so much for coming by.
Thanks for having us. We love your show. It's the coolest entrance ever.
Well, I've got to say, you do not look like your average pastor, Carl.
I've never heard that before.
Yeah, I bet you haven't. So how did this all come about? I know that you co-founded your church, I guess, in 2010 with Joel Houston. He's the front man of the Christian rock band Hillsong United. So how did this all come to be?
Well, first of all, our church started in Sydney, Australia. Brian and Bobby Houston. Planted a church like in the suburbs of Australia, and 30 years later they just felt like it was time to do something in America. And then when we kind of had the dream, my wife's here, she's the hot Australian in the front row. I talked to Joel one night in New York, and he said, my dad wants to do something, you know, in New York City. And I said, who's going to do it? He said, we should do it. And I'm like, man, that sounds impossible. Let's give it a shot. And that's kind of as simple as the story is. Right?
And it's grown, I mean, tremendously in the last 3 years. You have something like, I know you have rolling services.
Yep.
Is that the right way to describe it?
Why don't you come and check it out?
I want to. Okay. I really do want to come and check it out. But I understand you get 6,000 people every weekend coming to your services.
I don't know if it's that
services.
Many, but we got a good number of people. It's fun. Yeah.
And it's a Pentecostal church. So when I think of Pentecostal churches, Carl, I immediately think people are standing up and speaking in tongues.
Everything weird is what you normally think.
I do. So can you explain exactly what your Pentecostal church specifically is all about?
Yeah, I think we believe that term Pentecostal, in America we try to stay away from terms like denominations and Pentecostal. Typically, that's when people think of the weirdest, most awkward stuff in church. Sometimes that's the label. In our church, we do believe in the power of God. We do believe that, you know, the gifts that the Bible says you can have are real, but we believe the supernatural doesn't have to be super spooky.
Uh-huh.
And I think that's a big difference. So if you came to our church, I don't think you'd see anything that would just make you go, other than a disco ball that's going above your head, and that we meet in a club. Other than that, I don't think you'd feel like this is so weird that I can't, you know, even learn or hear the message.
Well, tell me about the vibe of your church, because obviously I think that's part of the appeal.
Yeah.
It doesn't feel like you're in church. You're not. It's not all quiet, and everybody isn't sitting in a pew.
Yeah.
Do you think, obviously, that's one of the draws and that's why people want to come?
Yeah, typically. I have yet to meet anybody in New York, and I'm like, hey, come to church. And they're like, yes, that sounds awesome. And so it's
I don't know.
No, I'm serious. Like,
really?
Rarely, because typically in New York, if you say church, like if I tell someone I'm a pastor, you would have thought I said, I don't like your mom or your cooking's bad. Yeah, because up until that point, everybody's cool. And then whatever they have in their head of what a pastor was to them, we get that label. And the same thing with church. So we have a big weapon in that our church meets in a club, because that most people recognize the club. And so it's easier, it's more palatable to come into a place you recognize. And our music is good. Sometimes people are in church and they're hearing the music and they're just like tolerating it, like, God, please save me from the service, like, end this now. And our music is actually, whether you believe the content of the lyrics, the music itself is good. So that's a big win. Yeah.
Now, how does your message differ? We heard Joel Osteen talk about sort of what he preaches, his philosophy. So what is your philosophy, Carl?
Well, first of all, I love Joel, and I'm thankful for men like him who have paved the way for younger guys like me to have an opportunity to do what we do. Joel is a pioneer, and his message of hope is similar to ours. I think I probably am a little bit louder. We have similar tattoos. No, Joel doesn't have it. I think we both believe that Jesus can change your life, and even though it says modern religion, I don't think we're religious. I think we promote a relationship with God. Like, religion is something that you do because you have to. We believe a relationship with Jesus is something you choose to do. Like, we want to be in church. No one's making us be there. This isn't something that, you know, your mom said, hey, you have to be a Christian or you have to be this. We believe you can actually have a relationship with God, and it's pretty special.
And how do you feel about sort of the tolerance issue that I was talking to Joel about? I mean, do you guys have positions on, say, gay marriage and things like that?
We have a stance on love, and everything else we have conversations.
Mm-hmm. So what does that mean?
Exactly that. often people want you to make these big statements, about things, and I don't believe it's fair. I don't think a public forum is always the best place to talk about something that's so sensitive and important to so many, because a public forum, there's no discussion there. And everybody's situation is unique. So I've been with some people who are, you know, make a statement about this, and I'll say, why? I'd rather have a conversation with that person, because if I make a statement publicly, there's no discussion, there's no explanation, there's just this comment, and we want
to just to play devil's advocate. I mean, do you feel like
that's hard for you because you're so sweet?
but do you feel like, you know, there you have a moral imperative to speak publicly about some of these more controversial issues?
No, because we try to be like Jesus. Very rarely did Jesus ever talk about morality or social issues. He was about the deeper things of the heart. And often people want to talk about behavior modification. Our church isn't about that. You can get behavior modification doing yoga or going to a karaoke thing. You can change a little bit about you. We're about soul transformation. So you start talking about some of the symptomatic stuff, that's not what we're about. We're about talking to people about their heart and their condition of their soul. And some of that stuff outworks itself, but we're not trying to change anybody because we can't.